I don't know how to hold it. I don't know.
Look, you have to hold it like this, mate.
Yeah. Look. Oh! You can lean forward and.
Of course you can. You have to. You know what? This is the way to do it. Look, you have to go like this.
Okay. Have you ever seen a Nigerian play darts?
We're the first three. We're the first. We're pioneers, you know. I know.
Blew my mind, so I was like, right.
Ooh. Yes.
Oh, no.
Fam.
Uncle Ian.
Hey, come on. Come on.
It's good to meet
you,
bro.
Good to meet you,
man.
Honestly,
I'm so pleased to meet the man. Hey, you don't even know. You don't know. You don't know.
Right,
honestly.
Now.
See my games, bro? Look, I got games in
it. I mean, yeah.
What games did you like play when you were younger? Cricket, basketball, what did you like to do? You're playing games?
We're footballers.
You're footballers? Well, what position?
I used to play up front, like yourself. Do you know what I mean?
You look like a centre half.
Nah, mate, I'm Emil Heskey, mate.
Tej, I need you to come in and do stuff. Right. So start now so as I can see what you're doing, because it's started. It's already started.
Right.
One-hand business. Right. Tej, you're going too hard. Get a rhythm. Get a rhythm. Did you play?
Yeah!
There he is! What's happening? How's everything going with you, bro? Everything cool?
Yeah, I'm all good. Half got the member of the All Black.
Just played it safe. Yeah.
Come on, look, sit here. Because how old was you when you first went to the Academy Arsenal?
I signed at nine.
Nine?
Yeah.
You came through, bro. You got through there. You got into the first team.
It was unexpected because obviously I weren't favourite at the time. There were so many people my age that were very talented, but most of them went on loan, where I didn't have to go on loan. So I was always training and training, waiting for my chance. And obviously Arsene Wenger at the time, very patient man, he gave me an opportunity and I was able to take it.
What was your parents, were they happy for you to do
of
that?
Of course. My dad, his dream was to play football in Nigeria, but obviously it wasn't the case.
And JJ Okocha?
Oh, quite brilliant from Okocha.
JJ Okocha's your uncle, bro?
Yeah. Blood uncle, my mum's younger brother.
Mm. So your mum's always been in and around and supporting, and your dad as well?
Yeah, always.
What about the man then? What about your friend? What about you, TJ? What was it like when you was growing up?
I got my first drum kit when I was 3 years old.
Wow.
Yeah. Argos.
How comes? Like, because, like, why a drum kit? What?
If it wasn't the drum kit, it was the pots and pans. It was just...
Because it was hyper, man.
Yeah, I was insane. I needed something to hear.
Yes.
Then that progressed into, like, taking me to drum lessons all the time. And
Tej, what's your bassist, right?
Yeah, so I'm bass. At church, our bass guitar player, he left. So my dad bought me a bass guitar and I was just like, you need your church.
My parents, they just always saw something valuable in learning an instrument. I think it's a lot to do with something they couldn't have. They just loved seeing us two doing it.
I'm hearing you're dabbling in the music. What's going on with you, bro?
Just a hobby, man, me and my friends.
Did I see something flash up the other day with you? What have you done recently?
I saw you spinning bars, you know what I'm saying?
What are you doing now? Recently with Michael
Dapper. Yes.
did something with him in my booth. I have a booth at home, innit? Recording studio.
So what, are you working? Are you writing?
Nah, it's just like, obviously it's something to take my mind off football sometimes, that me and my friends do, that just to express life through music.
Right. Is that what you're taking as your kind of release?
Yeah, my time to chill, like therapy. My boys call it therapy. And I see, was it Chipmunk that said rap is in therapy? And ever since I heard that, I was like, a decent saying.
Is it rap is therapy?
Rap is in the middle of therapy.
Right.
That blew my mind. So I'm like,
where's your release valve? What is it?
It's football.
How can you come to football for release, bro? That's where the pressure is. Because now my release is golf, bro. I just want to see what man gets and see if man can perform under pressure, man. So here it comes.
All right, cool.
Too hard. Look at it. Yes.
Yeah, he's getting it now. He's got his flow.
Look at that.
You're meant to be on my side.
Look at this drummer with no rhythm. Look at this.
When do you get
to? 22. Yes. 8 seconds.
Happens,
isn't it? Yes.
It's all right.
Yes. All right. Hey, I'm gonna remind you what.
Congrats.
I did a lot better than I expected, actually.
Hang on a minute. 38 to beat, bro. I'm going for raw pace. Yeah. He's got 15 seconds, though. There's the pressure. You done it. So, Alex Iwobi, 54, bro. I like that.
Nice stuff.
The other day, I was looking at some of your goals. And then I saw the first one, unbelievable, because it was against Everton. Let me get it up, look. You remember it?
Yeah, of course.
Now Bearing can look up and see Iwobi.
Feels like it was yesterday, you know?
Wow. Trying to get away from Funes Mori. It's Alex Iwobi!
Hang on, let me show the man.
Young me, boy. Yeah. Right.
Show the man before. Do you remember this goal,
Ben? Yeah.
So out.
The celebration, I remember.
Yeah, the celebration, exactly.
What's the celebration about? Because look at man's shooting, he's shooting arrows.
Obviously, it was meant to be a gun, because obviously, Arsenal, I'm a young gunner, so I don't know what I was doing.
First Gunners goal on full Premier League debut.
What was it like when you get into the Arsenal first team and score? How did you feel there?
It's hard to describe, but like the first people I called were my parents. It was crazy. My mum was dancing. It was FaceTime. My mum was dancing. My dad's like, oh my God, I can't believe you've done that. It was so much to take in.
When was the last time we got in touch? I think I gave you some love somewhere. I think your mum, did your mum tell you?
Yeah, my mum and dad. Even when I told them to come in, my dad was very excited.
He's got the record.
Wow.
It's a good system though.
You're turning the wrong way. Because look, you're this way to like this way. Well, you need to be this way to go this way.
Ah, cool.
So lean in, yeah, like that, then lean in.
Oh!
Yeah. Hey, can you edit that though?
Come on. Where do you even start, like, creatively? How do you get, like...
It's just, like, it just comes, like...
Yeah. We need more than that, man. We're trying to tell...
you know what it is? The rest of the band in Ezra, it always, like, whatever we're doing, we're the best in the band at that thing. So Femi is the best drummer in Ezra.
Right.
I'm the best bassist in Ezra. Yeah, and so we play to our strength.
Here's something, you're just, like... When you're nodding your head and you're, like, what kind of rhythm would I put to that? Oh, yeah. And then you can actually play it. You just put it down.
Is that the same vibe, Al, with when people say, like, if you do skill or do something, how do you do that? It just comes.
Oh, yeah, instinct, yeah. You don't just plan that you're going to do something. Well, I don't. And you know, I don't see if a defender, I'm going to try to step over. It's good, because everyone's different. Whether my feet just do.
Yeah, but I've just got so much faith in my ability to just create on the spot. I'll go for a run. In the middle of the run, I'll be like, I've got a rhythm. Record it.
No, what you just record, go...
Honestly, this guy will bring voice notes into
just
the,
be like,
into the recorded.
Play this like, voice play note. This.
Yeah. Are you doing something now? What are you doing?
I'm trying to find the voice note I made for Victory Dance.
Yeah.
Yeah, here we go. I found it. This was the original version.
Play again, bro. Play again, because like we've got some vibe with it now, bro. Yeah.
This is so sick, man.
Oh my God.
Oh, hard.
Oh my days.
And you know, like the fanfare when you win a war. Bum, 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 bum.
Yeah.
I started thinking of that trumpet line that they do when they win a war. Because I'm about to finish this run, it's going to be a victory. Fanfare, but make it sound cool. And then. And then once it's like, oh, that sounds cool, then I sing it into there. Then I start to demand them. And then they just make it fun.
That is so hard.
That's the musical journey.
Tell people who don't know who Tony Allen is, bro.
People would credit him for creating Afrobeat.
Wow.
That drum beat, that's that pattern, big. The most iconic music that's come out of Africa. So I'm playing the drums and someone comes up to me, he's like, who's your favorite ever drummer? And I'm like, oh, Tony Allen, drummer for Fela Kuti. And the guy just laughed and walked off, which I thought was very odd. Mm-hmm. Yeah. He then came back and just handed me a mobile phone, like real MI5 vibes. And I'm like, hello? And then it was Tony Allen on the wow. other side of the phone. And I was just like, that kind of young, youthful, I was just brave, I didn't care. I was like, I would love to have lessons with you. Wow. And he was like, okay, come to my house and we can play. And when I got the address, that's when I saw it was in Paris. I just assumed, you know, everyone.
So wait a minute, did you have to find money to get there and do all this stuff?
I found the Megabus goes from Victoria to Paris. It's 11
pounds. Megabus.
Yeah, man, it was 11 pounds. You leave at 10 p.m., you get to Paris at 6 a.m. My lesson was at 4 p.m., so I just walk around. I know Paris, like, if you need anything in Paris, I know it at the back of my hand. I just walk around.
How old was you?
This is first year uni, so probably 19 years old. He taught me a lot of drums, but the best thing he taught me was just like, be yourself and do your thing, do you know what I mean? Tell me about taking penalties. Because I can't lie, it's so easy when you've never had to do it. To just be like, what's wrong with you? Just put it in the bottom corner, bro.
I had a routine with a penalty. I'd get the ball, put the ball down, 3 steps back, and my go-to penalty is Harry Kane's in the World Cup.
Which one?
You know what I mean? That's the one. Goalkeepers right, bam. Well, obviously the first one. Obviously the first one, bro. You know what I mean? But that's what I'm saying, Al. What's your penalties like?
Yeah, I have a routine of mine as well. I'm not going to give it away in case.
My grandson now, he's at Stoke. He's kind of frustrated that, you know, he's not playing as often as he can. And I'm trying to make him understand that to be a footballer in itself, how much people want to do that.
Of course.
I'm trying to explain how important the journey is. Yeah. The work you have to do.
Yeah.
With you guys, when did the work kick in? When did it happen?
So when I went to uni, I was at music college. And my schedule was just insane. I'd have to teach the drums in a secondary school. I loved it, but it was also just the means of survival kind of thing. Once I'd wrapped that up, I would go to these jam sessions and play the drums in like Ronnie Scott's or something till 4 o'clock in the morning. You haven't been sleeping, you've been practicing all day. And then 3 o'clock in the morning, a saxophone player would just be like, man, you don't sound that good.
Wow.
Like, we weren't making no fees from music. So it was like, so that was the hardship. It was, I mean, our first tour, I remember driving back from Bristol, going to my 9 a.m. lecture, finishing the lecture, getting in the car, driving to Brighton, playing the gig come back from my lecture. That was like the first UK tour that we did. And still for no peas, it was like.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
So it's in those moments where you start to really ask, like, is this what I want to be doing? Mm. But I remember before I went to uni, my dad looked me in the eyes, he said, you can do whatever is in front of you. Mm. And it was like that little,
did something turn on in you?
100%. That was like a defining moment of my life. Mm. And if it weren't for that, I would have quit bass.
Yeah. Do you go back to that moment?
All the time, all the time. I've got it written down in my phone somewhere. It's just like that.
Motivation.
Yeah.
When could you look back at yourself, Alex, and say, you know what, this is a tough time for me?
Around 13, 14, when obviously I'm one of the youngest in my school year. Mm. So I'm the last one, I was one of the last ones to grow.
Right.
And then at Arsenal, I'm being told, like, you're not strong enough, you're not good enough. So hearing a lot of negativity.
Did it affect your game? Did it affect the way you played?
At times, yeah. I'm going into games and I'd not really want to receive the ball and express myself.
Wow.
And my dad even clocked it as well. He said, I don't want to waste my time bringing you here if you're not going to play how you want to play, like play when you're playing with your friends sort of thing. So like, it was tough at the time, but I've always had the support from my mum, dad, my uncle saying, of course, like football's a way to express yourself, like always play with a smile on your face. I'm obviously watching my uncle do that.
Mm.
It would motivate me to go and do the same thing. So it was tough. It's always been tough.
Yeah,
there's
man.
Many tough periods in my life.
That was a time, because when you look at what you're doing now, and anybody speaks about Everton, you're the first person they speak about. You're the positive. Mm. There was a time I was worried for you when you first got there. I felt like I had to do a lot of bam, 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 just putting out these fires because people were going at you. How did you get through the negativity of the amount of money that people are saying that you cost to go to Everton?
My first 2 years obviously weren't nice. You're just seeing a lot of abuse. You're coming to training, you know you're not going to play. But it was a bit hard because obviously I moved up north by myself. But my family and friends would come and every now and again. But not
so really. Wait a minute. So through that kind of dark time, you wasn't going out anywhere. You're just in the house.
No, I was in my apartment. But sometimes when I'm by myself, I'm just thinking, oh, I'm going training the next day. I'm just thinking, oh. And sometimes just to clear my head, I'll go out for a run. It's cold. Up north it's so cold. But I was just thinking, oh, I need to do something. Like, I just feel like nothing's working. I need to do something. But luckily for me, I would always go away with my national team and do okay.
I'm just interested in the Nigeria. And what was it about it? What was it, the vibe?
Everyone comes there, like, it's almost like a party. Like, you just forget about all your problems. Everyone just wants to play football with a smile on their face, want to entertain. It's just a culture that Nigeria, like, brings. That like, when you're going to games, you're hearing trumpets, you're hearing drums, you're hearing everything. So it's almost like you're playing, like, you're almost on stage, like a theatre. If you have a good touch, they're clapping, they appreciate everything, like, it's crazy.
I'll be expert at this by the time we finish doing this show, bro.
Yeah,
with a wrist. What? You got a wrist in it? Did let me see if I can get 100.
The pressure's there.
Oh, you got it.
Smooth. Bam. Right, Teej, you're on.
They're finally out here.
Come on, 100 points you got to get. 5. 4, 3, 2. You see the pressure? Fems, you're on.
Come on, I'll be better compared.
Yeah. Wow, Fem. Come on, Fem, 100 points.
The 100's dead, the 100's dead. The 100's dead, the 100's dead.
Yeah!
I've done all right.
Alex, 106 to beat. 1. Four. Alex is killing it.
Oh no!
Yes! Al, see what you can get.
All right, cool.
Oh. Yeah, I'm warm.
Are you warm?
I'm warm.
Yes.
I'm warm.
Hey!
Yeah.
Oh my God,
that's the move!
2.
3. 2. Right. 146, man.
No.
Thank you.
Big love.
Thanks for coming.
I love you. Big love.
100. 100. I'm coming.